this video, you will see an introduction to Jupyter Lab and Jupyter Notebooks. Jupyter Notebooks help you share and collaborate code. Let's create a new notebook. To start, choose the File menu and choose New Notebook. The Select Kernel dialog appears. Select Teradata SQL as the kernel. Think of a kernel as a processing engine for the notebook. We have four to choose from: Python, Julia, R, and Teradata SQL. Notice the notebook is named untitled.ipynb. The name appears at the top of the notebook and on the left in the file browser pane. This notebook has one cell where you can enter text or code. From the Edit menu, you can change your cells, cut, copy, and paste, and more. From the View menu, you can change what is seen in the notebook and which Jupyter Lab panes are visible. From the Run menu, you can choose what part of your notebook to run. From the Kernel menu, you can stop and start kernels. From the Tabs menu, you can navigate between open notebooks. From the Settings menu, you can change how Jupyter Lab displays. Themes and font size are here. From the Help tab, you can find relevant information about Jupyter and your kernels. What displays in the left pane can change based on the icon you choose down the left navigation bar. Right now, the pane is displaying the file browser. Let's open a Teradata SQL notebook from the file browser pane. Navigate to Sample Notebooks, SQL, and open gettingstarted.ipynb. Notice above the folder and file names there is the folder structure you are in. You can navigate by clicking these. Click the small folder icon and you will go back to your home folder. You can also collapse the left pane by clicking the active icon. In our case, the file browser. You can click again on the icon to open the pane again. The second icon down displays running terminals and kernels. You can stop these from here. The third icon shows you a list of commands. These same commands can also be found in the traditional drop-down menus you saw earlier. The fourth icon is the Property Inspector, followed by a list of open tabs. The orange and white Teradata icon is where you can manage your connections to Teradata. We have three listed. The next icon is a table of contents for the open tab. The final icon is the extension manager. Here you can add or remove third-party extensions. From the Getting Started demo tab, let's run our first cell. Place your cursor to the left of the first square brackets. You can click the Run button from the icons at the top of the notebook, or you can choose the Run drop-down menu. If you choose the drop-down menu, Run Selected Cells, which has a keyboard shortcut of Shift-Enter. Notice Alt-Enter will run the cell and create a new blank cell below, the Run cell. Choose Run Selected Cell. The blank inside the first square brackets now says 1. Each time you run a cell, the number will increment by 1. You can choose Run again in the next code cell. In this video, you're introduced to Jupyter Lab and Jupyter Notebooks.